arrived at part 3, the conclusion, and believe me, this is where things get worse. I unlocked the passageway to Iggy's volcanic castle, though you don't want to know how the heck I went through that, believe me. And I got myself another mushroom, since I gotta prepare myself accordingly. For now, let's tackle the 7th area, and then we'll tackle the secret one. Here we are at Wiggler Stampede, and the theme of it is just Wigglers, no surprise, but there are also giant Wigglers. You could use the giant Wigglers to be platformed, then you'll be able to use them to like progress and unlock hidden things. Like for example, this star coin here on the left. You need to wait till like the Wiggler goes all the way to the right, and then when it goes all the way to the left, jump on it and you should be able to make it. If you know what you're doing, you won't die, and that's a good thing. And since I have an acorn suit, you can be able to get some of the star coins easily. And you don't have to worry about dying from the poisoned water, though it's nothing compared to having me deal with something else later. And like that, this is another one. To get the second star coin here, you need to use the giant Wiggler to be able to like hit a block that like reveals a vine, and you should be able to make it up there. And I gotta be careful since I don't want to stop on the vine and lose the pipe. Though I had to wait till it drops down because I was just taking a lot of tries, and finally I made it. And I did it a bit too high, and that was too close for comfort. And now we reach another vine upwards, and this one you need to hit blocks to form vines so that way you can be able to reach up there. Like so. And like that. That's it, since right now you just climb up and the star coin's right there. Just wait till it comes to you and that's it. And that's about it. Getting star coin number 3 will be pretty easy too, since with the acorn suit, you'll be able to get it. Yeah, I don't really have that much to say, though it's nothing compared to what's gonna happen later on. I gotta wait till the thing goes all the way on the left side, and then you hit the P-switch. This next part here is just a true test of skill. Why? Because you have to hit constant P-switches repeatedly, so that way you'll be able to progress and continue. Because if not, then you'll be trapped, and that'll be a problem. Then I was lucky to even hit that switch. I was really lucky to hit that. And I'm making all the way up higher than ever before, collecting coins, and like that, I make it look easy. Now this next part here, you have to go up. While it goes up, it goes down underwater. And if you touch the poison water, you're dead. That's simple. Wait till it rises, and then you can continue on per usual. Though you can always hold your jump button so that way you can progress, and you'll be able to reach the higher platforms with ease. Yeah, I know, since I make it look easy. And I hit a Wiggler by accident, and when you hit the Wigglers, they get really angry. They do get really angry, and you don't want to get them mad. Anyway, this last part here is actually pretty easy, since you need to get the star coin that's like all the way down below, like there. There, see that right there? There are two ways. You could actually use the super acorn to go up, or you can be on the safe side and wait for the Wiggler to rise up, and then you get it. That's simple. It's actually pretty easy. It's a pretty easy level if you know what you're doing. Since I really took my time on this, since quite frankly, I always take my time on levels like these. And like that, I progress, and I think I timed my height a little too high, but whatever. It doesn't really matter since I got what I needed. I got the star coin. That's simple. That's it. It's done. Though I do feel it could have been better, and I did it without taking damage, so I'm not complaining with that. And we unlock another passageway to Iggy's castle, but we're not going to Iggy's castle yet. Why? Because we got to go all the way back around into the dark forest. And you'll be able to, and yes, I hit down by accident. Why did I do that? I don't know. And we now head downwards. And this is, I believe, at this point where the death count decides to say, you know what? You've been doing too good. Now you need to die. And believe me, I died twice. It's not a laughing matter if you die twice. I'm only saying this because, quite frankly, we're now progressing through the fight of the Parabeetles. And yes, this level is where things really become a bind for you, because quite frankly, you're on top of Parabeetles, and depending on what Parabeetle you stand up on, some will rise, others will not. The smaller ones will rise upwards as you get on them, though the bigger ones, which you see right here, go down as you progress now. You need to use this to your advantage if you can be able, if you'll be able to progress. And I believe this is where I believe I die at this point. Yeah, this is where I die, though quite frankly, I really wasn't paying attention to what I was doing. I was like, I needed to keep my eyes open on the sky above, and these Parabeetles, jumping one Parabeetle after another, and they'll fall, and that could be bad. Since you now have to switch between big Parabeetle and small Parabeetle, you'll be able to like reach higher. And this is at this point where I'm actually screwing up, because the second star coin is right nearby. And who would it be right by than to get in my way here? Well, a giant, massive bullet bill. And you're gonna see it right here, believe me, here it is. It's gonna come about right about now, and this is where I got hit, and I fall to my death. Wow, I can't believe I got hit by a parabeetle. That sucks. Now my death count's at 3, and that's not a pretty good thing. Doesn't matter anyway, because in special levels like these, there are no checkpoints. We have to go through it all over again. And I would have used a mushroom, but I decided to use the squirrel suit since I really need to get it over with. I'm almost at the end and I keep on messing up. What do you expect me to do? I mean, come on, I'm at least trying. And now it's time we try again. And this time I know what I'm doing this time. This time I'm just going to be cautious. I'm just going to be careful because I really, really don't want to mess up here. I really don't. And now we continue on our way as usual. And this time we are progressing through. Remember what I said before? Remember what I explained before? Remember, the small parabeetles, as you land on them, they go up. The bigger parabeetles, as you go on them, they go down. Use them to your advantage if you'll be able to reach higher platforms. Though, quite frankly, if you really know what you're doing, you should be able to get the level done really easily. Though, right here, I must have touched the ring and it got me the coins right above. And I'm trying my hardest not to fall and I missed the 1-up. Not that it matters since I get an extra life either way. Like that. I'm at 99 lives again. You're gonna notice me as I lose and gain lives that I keep my life counter at 99. Except for World 7, which I end at 98. I'm not complaining since I get like lots of lives every time. And this last one here, you just gotta wait for that to drop, though there is actually an easier way. Get on one of the giant parabeetles and let it drop. By doing this, you'll be able to get the second star coin easily. And like that, I make it look easy. Though right now, I gotta keep on moving, and holy shit, giant bullet bill. I apologize for that, since quite frankly, I really don't want to die. I really don't want to die a lot, and I gotta make it up there, and thank God. These giant, huge bullet bills are, like, huge. They're, like, really freaking huge. And I'm like, when I got hit by, like, when I fall to my death, I'm like, the first time, I'm like, oh my God, why this? And these bullet bills are massively huge. Did I mention that they're huge? Yes, I did. I did mention that they're huge. And they keep on going. Though, to get the third star coin, you need to, like, time your jump right. And, like, you need to have the parabeetle reach at a position where you, like, can reach upwards. Though, if you get hit, and I got hit like that, and it sucks. Though, you can use the repeated giant, like, these parabeetles to be able to make it. Just make sure you time it right, and you'll be able to. And like that, I was really lucky to make it. I really was lucky. And the third star coin is pretty easy. Though if I still had, I think, the squirrel suit, I would have been able to make it. And like that, not that it matters since I get another extra 1-up. And I'm not complaining. I'm at least doing my best here. Anyway, that's about it. I already completed the flight of the parabeetles and got all 3 star coins on the course. Yeah, it was intense, but what can you do? And with it, you unlock your passageway to World 7, avoiding World 6 entirely. I would have used it if I would have gotten the chance, but... And yes, you have the option to save, but I decided not to. Now I gotta go all the way down, all the way to the castle, and continue it there. Yeah, since quite frankly, I don't really do much. Yeah, I also gotta do commentary for World 6 and World 7, not to mention all the videos for 3D Land. And quite frankly, if you know what you're doing here, you'll be able to avoid these boos entirely. Like that. I make it look easy. Better luck next time, boos! Anyway, with all that said and done, we now tackle the castle for Soda Jungle, Iggy's Volcanic Castle. Now you're asking yourself this question, volcanic in a forest? Video game logic, you could pretty much not care less about it. Though if you do get touched by the lava, that's it, you're dead. And believe me, it took me so many tries because I really had a hard time with this level. And I believe this is also where I die. Again, this is actually the 4th time. There are actually 2 ways to get the first star coin. Though both of them are risky because of the rising lava currents. Yeah, if you notice how the currents are rising and falling. Like, rise, fall, rise, fall. It's like a wave. Though if you get hit by the wave, you're dead. And you don't really want to go through that, right? Anyway, I keep on going. I got to avoid everything since it's a real mess this is. And I didn't go through and I didn't get my extra life. That sucks, so you know what? Screw it. Anyway, to get the first star coin here, you need to time like a dry bones to get there. But you need to time it in a position where you can actually like touch like the star coin and not get hit by the lava. If the thing touches the lava, it melts. And you don't want to go through that, right? It took me a lot of tries just to like make it through. And I didn't really know what I was doing. And I thought it was okay to just make it down there and get it. But I was so nervous. I was like freaking out and I didn't really know what I was doing. I just had to wait it out. But then I was a bit too late and it went over and I'm like, damn it, why did it do that? And I thought the best way to do it is to just risk it, but I died. And my death count now is at 4. Yes, I'm complaining for the matter, and if you notice by the complaints in the video with these, like, these little notes, you got what I mean. And that got me really angry, so you know what? I'm back to Iceflower again. Let's get back in there, and let's get this over with. Yes, this won't be the last time I die, believe me. I'm trying to keep my deaths as minimum as possible, because let's face it. You want to get through the game at 100%? Sometimes you got to take risks, you got to take sacrifices. It's what you do as a player. And to let you know, I'm not a Let's Player. Not anymore, since I've disassociated myself with this. I don't want to go through that whole story again, and I don't want to, like, bother you about it, since it's a hassle. Anyway, like before, you got to watch out. You got to watch out for the lava, because if you get hit by the lava, you're dead, and you don't want to go through that. Like that. And once you're high enough, you'll be able to get an extra life, and like that. I got the extra life. Though I got to watch out here, because if I get hit by the lava, I die, and that's it. I'm done. Anyway, let's just time it here. You gotta make sure the platform is low enough. I was thinking maybe I could take the risk, but I did it, and the flame actually melted the dry bones. And the dry bones just make it way too easy to get over there. And like that, I got him again. Yeah, sometimes the game can screw you over, and other times the game can just say, you know what, let's just be lenient on him and just give him what he wants. And I got myself star coin number 1. Thank God. Now I gotta wait for star coin number 2. And star coin number 2 was actually the hardest star coin I've ever gotten in this level. The only reason why I say it is the hardest is because of the fact you need to time your jump on the dry bone so that way you can be able to reach a pipe up above. Made worse by the fact that the lava flow makes it that much more harder for you just to progress. Yes, it is hard, and what do you expect? Anyway, I get myself an extra life. That's null and void, considering I always get lots of extra lives. And this is the part right here where I had a really hard time with this level. Yeah, I really mean it. I had a hard time because I wanted to time my jump. But the platform right there is so low, you need to time your jump from a dry bones just to progress it. It took me like many tries, and I was just literally angry by that matter. I thought I was going to get it and nailed it. But another factor is that the dry bones can sometimes move when it wants to. And when it wants to, it doesn't give you what you want. That makes me angry, and I get angry for that. Anyway, I make it up there, and I was too late yet again, and that got me angry. So I hope the third time is always the charm. Too bad it saved me. I was grateful that it did save me from a lava death. Dear God, I hate stuff like that, but I'm grateful that it did. And I gotta make sure this time I time it right, and it didn't get hit again. And it gets really tiring. I could just fast forward all the way, but no, you're gonna be hearing my difficulty through in this level. And finally it gets up there. Finally. Now this part here is pretty easy. Take power block, whack, like so, and you'll be able to take out dry bones and get yourself star coin. And if you have plenty of coins, you'll get yourself another 1-up. I've already wasted enough time and I was already angry. I was just fuming mad from this level. I know a lot of people died here just trying to progress and trying to get everything. It's a hassle. And you gotta deal with these hotheads. These hotheads are a pain in the butt. Though, if you know what you're doing, you can just dodge them easily, and you'll be able to progress. And this last coin here, you need to take this green pipe. Though, you have to wait for the current to, like, move out of the way, so that way you'll be able to get clearance. And like that, I'm lucky to even make it. So, the last coin's pretty easy, since some of the super dry bones are having a lava bath. Touch the lava and you're dead. That's simple. Though, if you had the squirrel suit, it would've been pretty easy doing that. Anyway, I make it through, get the third star coin, and I'm done. That's simple. I'm already done here, since now I gotta take on Iggy Koopa. And Iggy thinks he's so hip trying to get his way working for Bowser. Yes, we already know that it's been retconned. Retconned that the Koopalings are not Bowser's kids. That, I believe, is a problem. Iggy, or Hop Koopa, is actually the fourth oldest. And boy, oh boy, why do I feel that his hair looks like a palm tree? Yeah, his hair does look like a palm tree. And let's just make it up there and get it over with, since the fight itself is already a pain in the butt. Yeah, this whole boss fight is just a pain. Iggy's gonna reach one of these pipes up above and then use his magic to fire 3 beams at you. The red beam is the one you have to avoid, since it's gonna summon a large blarg. Though if you use ice flowers on it, it isn't that hard. It'll just shrink down and that's it. Though this part here is a bit tricky, since he can actually use the pipes to gain leverage, and this is where I screw up and got hit. and I get hit actually twice, since this is majorly a pain. If you know what you're doing and you know where he's at, and I got hit, not that it matters since I'm already fuming angry over this, you'll be able to make it through. You just gotta watch out because you're gonna need to make sure not to get hit. You don't really want to get hit, believe me. And if he goes up on the other side, now it's going to take a longer time just to make it up there. And like that, I was too late. But oh no. Oh no, you don't. No. I've had enough dealing with you, and so did Sasuke. And I'm done with that.
What?
And thank God, that's over. Sheesh. I believe, according to the games, Iggy is depicted as a demented mechanical genius. Why do you think he made this castle to begin with? And with it, Iggy just hopped his way out of here. Thank God that's over. My God. Don't worry, it's not going to be like this in the later worlds. Things actually get easier. And with it, we unlock a passageway to World 6. And we've collected all the star coins in Soda Jungle. That to me is good. That's about it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time in World 6. Take care.